Mike Zaplin, or as he is known as Zappy, is known for many things. He's known as a domain guru, someone who saw in advance that domain names were something that could be of value. And then he has shifted gears. He's a cannabis entrepreneur, but really what Zappy is known most for right now is his support of psychedelic treatments. And we're going to talk to Zappy about that today. So you've done several things. You've had a movie, a documentary called The Reality of Truth. But more recently, you have a new documentary with Lamar Odom, and you have The Mind Army, which is an effort to start to legalize some of the psychedelic treatments that are out there. What got you from this is a crazy shift from someone who got their money from selling domain names, very high tech kind of thing, to now going into psychedelics? What was that shift that happened?
Yeah, that was, you know, that was a really organic shift. It was, you know, just in my own life, I think I was having this, you know, spiritual midlife crisis where I felt like I did everything that society told me I needed to do to be completely fulfilled. And when I had done it all, I was sitting there going, wow, you know what? I'm happy and I'm having some nice experiences, but I'm not fulfilled. I don't like really even know why I'm here, you know, in this human incarnation. And so it occurred to me, based on having had some really good psychedelic experiences when I was younger, you know, that were just sort of like most teenagers experimenting and things like that. But I did see some value in it. It was good experiences. So when I hit this kind of wall 10 years ago, I thought, wow, you know, this is like a moment where maybe I got to turn back to these psychedelics. Maybe I'd been hearing about ayahuasca and San Pedro, some of these master healing plants. And I thought, wow, you know, if I did that, but I did it with the right intent of expanding my consciousness, maybe I could really get some, you know, big benefit from this. And I did that. And that's really the basis for the movie, The Reality of Truth, was that experience I was going through. I needed to have that for myself. And I wound up, you know, with a group, including Michelle Rodriguez, the actress, going down to Peru and sitting with shamans. And so that experience for me was transformational. I realized what the value of these, you know, master healing plants were. And I started to incorporate that into my life. And I saw my life getting better and better, more fulfillment. And I thought to myself, you know, I got to tell everybody about this, you know, which is kind of what happened when I came back from Peru. I was telling everybody about how much these things had helped me and that I thought everybody should go, you know, experience this.
I think, yeah, you know, with the cannabis experience, you know, for a lot of people, to your point, they had an experience in their youth and it wasn't super overwhelming. And so it was a very mild experience. It wasn't very scary. But then you start to go into the idea of psychedelics, and for a lot of people, that's just a bridge too far. It's a little scary. You know, the word trip, being out of control, it's a little bit, I don't want to say a harder sell, but it's a little bit, you know, a bigger jump for most people to go into that area.
Yeah, it is. You're totally right. I mean, I think right now we're in this, coming out of this pandemic or in this pandemic, and the crisis with suicide, addiction, depression, and now PTSD, I think it's kind of like catapulted this to the forefront where people are saying to themselves, you know what? I've tried the antidepressants and the talk therapy and all that kind of stuff. It didn't get me out of where I am right now. And then maybe they've tried cannabis and said to themselves, well, that was a good experience. It's not, you know, negative like they used to tell me it was. It was actually good for my health. But even the cannabis in this moment isn't triaging me like I need to. It's not going to stop a suicidal ideation or a drug addiction. It's a tool, but it's maybe, you know, if we weren't in this crisis, maybe those tools would be enough. But I think what's leapfrogged psychedelics right now is that we're in this crisis. And, you know, if we were watching this like a sci-fi movie right now, it's a really scary sci-fi movie. We've got all these horrifying things happening at the same time. Like what I consider cannabis is a psychedelic. It's just a very, very subtle one. Mm-hmm. So that you know, it's so subtle that it just gets you comfortable being in that present moment awareness state, maybe taking off some of the filters that naturally exist. And I think that's so brilliant of nature, like the trees shifting. It knows that humans are hurting and suffering from diseases that they need help with. And so to bring out this very subtle psychedelic, but that will get people tuned up for, you know, ayahuasca, iboga, San Pedro, these master healing plants.
You've created this movement, the Mind Army. Is the goal to try to get psychedelics legalized?
Yes. Thank you for asking. The Mind Army social movement, it's a 501c3 nonprofit. And we are fighting for the right to pursue happiness. That is our goal. And so we want psychedelics made legal right now during this crisis. And we believe that that is warranted. These materials, these compounds were made illegal back in 1966. And that was under the guise that we needed to check on the safety of them and make sure they were safe. Well, now here we are 54 years later, millions of people have had the experience, many with great benefit. And so we're not going to sit around anymore and just let, you know, the government or some agency tell us that, oh, okay, alcohol's good, tobacco's good, but somehow psilocybin mushrooms or iboga, those are not good. And they're in fact illegal. They're off the table for you, even if you're suicidal, have addiction or depression, post-traumatic stress, can't use them because we ruled on this, you know, 54 years ago. And we're just not accepting that. We understand basic modern science and medicine. We're saying, no, we are in charge of our bodies. We're not hurting anybody else. So if we need to, in this crisis, use some of these compounds, we are demanding the right to use them right now. And if it's Joe Biden, his son, Hunter Biden, had a drug and alcohol addiction issue. He used iboga, to the African root, to break that addiction. And so we intend to say to Joe Biden, if it's good enough for your son, it's good enough for everybody else. Get your pen out and write this executive order, because people are, you know, committing suicide and dying of overdoses at a scary rate. So we want to, you know, bring this task force forward. We also are putting together a Mind Army microdosing handbook. And in that handbook, we are going to show people that if you encounter cannabis, psilocybin, ayahuasca, iboga, here are the basic ways that you microdose that. Here's how to do it safely and effectively.
I noticed that a lot of your efforts have been either in a nonprofit way. You definitely don't seem like you are trying to cash in on this. It's a very organic, very personal effort that you're pursuing. There's definitely two camps in the psychedelic world. There's one side that is certainly seeing this from a financial opportunity. And then there's the other side that does not recognize it, that's kind of more on your end. You know, are you concerned about maybe some of these corporate companies trying to patent some of these compounds or trying to corner the market on them?
Yeah, I'm always going to be concerned about the pharmaceutical companies, because, you know, I'm okay with them bringing these compounds out, quite frankly, if that's what it takes and that's the easiest way, great. I don't want these things, you know, stripped of their value and some of their elements like they tend to do in that, you know, or have done in the past. But, you know, I actually wear both hats. I'm a capitalist myself. I worked on Wall Street. I don't think there's anything wrong with doing well and doing good. So I kind of am on two tracks. I have the nonprofit side, which is the Mind Army, and I have the for-profit, which is a company called Keda MD. And Keda MD is based around the compound of ketamine. It's not live right now. We're in a private beta. But what we're doing is, I have a movie coming out with Lamar Odom where he does the ketamine treatments and he does the iboga, and he really transforms his life in that documentary film. And so we know that when that movie airs early next year on the streaming platforms and all over the place, that there's going to be millions of people that become aware of these compounds and want to do it. So in order to help them, we're putting in place Keda MD, which is a virtual platform. for 1 hour, have an incredible experience, build new neural pathways in your brain. And if you look at it under a brain scan, you can see that when the ketamine is administered, your brain turns on 80% of your brain. So, you know, we always have these movies like The Limitless Drug, and everybody's like, oh, I wish we had that drug. And I'm like, we do. It's called ketamine. And we just need to educate people about that reality. And then I think, you know, everybody can be triaged in this moment with that.
Well, thank you so much, Zappy. I certainly enjoyed chatting with you, and I appreciate you taking the time to speak with us at Green Market Report today. We will keep our eyes out for the Mind Army and for your new documentary next year. And again, thank you for taking your time. I know that you're a busy man traveling all over the country and helping people. So thank you for spending some time with the Green Market Report.
Yeah, excellent. I appreciate your audience too. I think the folks that have been focused on the green market, I'll have a definite appreciation for the psychedelic market, because this is sort of going to be, a new class of assets that are really just in their infancy. So people like you shedding light on it is what's going to, you know, really allow people to make, you know, massive returns. So thank you.